Hi everyone. Today I want to shoot a quick follow-up to my YouTube subscription counter video. One of the questions that I've gotten more than any other was, can I make this into a clock? And the answer is, yes you can. It's a general purpose numeric display and you can set it whatever number you like. That includes the time of day. Let me show you.
Since the last time you've seen it, more people have subscribed to the channel. Also, the plants have taken over the shelf.
In order to change the subscription counter into a clock, we need to change the program running on the Wi-Fi module.
Surgery on electronics devices is always best with the power off.
Careful. And there it is. An ESP01 Wi-Fi module. The brains of the YouTube counter. If you are wondering how the numbers are actually passed through the modules, here's how it works. If we wanted to display, for example, the number 1234, we would print the number into a string and send it out over serial to the first module. Every time a module receives a string, it looks at the very last digit, clips it off, and displays it. Hopefully it's a number. The remainder of the string is then sent out over serial to the next module. There the whole process starts again. Look at the last digit, clip it off, display it, send the remainder off to the next module. Until we either run out of digits or modules. Alright, let's do this. Sorry about the mess, it always kinda looks like this. Here's what we're gonna need. A USB to serial adapter board. I'm using one with an FTDI chip on it. It can be switched from 5 to 3 volt, and in order to talk to the ESP module, we need to set it to 3.3. Our Wi-Fi module, a breadboard, and a bunch of wires. Nowadays, it's really easy to program the ESP module from within the Arduino environment. All you need to do is install the board with the board manager. The whole ESP Arduino integration is very well done and also well documented on the web, so I won't go into detail here, but I will leave some links in the description. The wiring is also super simple. I'm going to power the ESP module directly from the serial module. So VCC goes to VCC, ground goes to ground. Not directly though. I'm going to need access to VCC and ground in just a minute. As you would expect, RX on one module is connected to TX on the other module, and vice versa. That's two more wires. As I mentioned before, I'm going to need access to VCC and ground, so instead of connecting the ESP module directly, I'm going to power it through the power rails of the breadboard. While I'm fiddling with these wires, have a look at the schematic. These boards come in all shapes and colors, and your pinouts may be different to what you see here. Make sure you check the labeling of the pins on your specific boards. Two more wires to go. In order to program the little bug, we need to set its two GPIO pins 0 and 2 to specific logic levels, ground and VCC respectively. When it's powered up and finds those levels, it'll go into programming mode, and it's ready to accept our new code. For this test, I have hacked together a minimal version of a clock program. You can find it in the same Git repository that the rest of the code is in. Again, I'll leave a link in the description. Oh, and of course, since our code runs on a Wi-Fi module, there's no reason not to get the time from the internet. If you want to use the code as is, at least you have to change your Wi-Fi credentials and your time zone. Alright, that's it. All that's left to do now is plug it in and try it out. And energize. Directly after power-up, the segments have no memory of what number they displayed last, so they have to keep cycling forward until they find the magnet embedded in one of the gears. Once they find that, they know exactly where they are and can display each number directly. But it will take a moment. Surprisingly accurate. So, this video was a bit different, but I thought it was the quickest way to get through some of this stuff. I hope it was helpful. I hope you got a better understanding of how the whole thing works. Let me know what you think in the comments, and I will see you next time. Bye.